In this video, let's see another category of indefinite integration, which is partial fractions. So we know that we can integrate either by substitution or we can integrate by parts, and also integration by partial fractions is another important category. So why are we going to adopt this method and when are we going to adopt this method is important to know. As you know that integration can be done in various ways. We have learned many formulas. So when I talk about some fraction, means numerator upon denominator, the fraction may be called as a rational number, and there are basically two types of rational numbers. One rational number type is called as the proper rational number. The second type is called as the improper rational number. Now, proper rational numbers, I repeat, my proper rational numbers, I'm writing the word here, proper rational numbers, are those numbers wherein if a rational number given to you of the form px upon qx, so the degree of the numerator, which is px, will be less than the degree of the denominator. That type of a rational number is called as a proper rational number. And in case of a proper rational number, I would like to mention that the technique for integration of such rational numbers would be integration by partial fractions. But if the fraction is not a proper rational number but improper rational number, that means my degree of the numerator is either greater than or equal to the degree of the denominator, then you would go by the long division method and other methods that were suggested as we studied in the previous videos. So partial fractions, the depth we are going to study, we are going to dive into the concept of partial fractions. For that, I would like to enlist certain given forms. If your given form is like px plus q upon x minus a into x minus b, that means there are two factors in which it can be resolved, then it can be mentioned that a upon x minus a, b upon x minus b, where a, b are real numbers always, we are going to do with that sort. The next, if you are given the form of px plus q upon x minus a whole square, that means the denominator is a whole square, then the form would be a upon x minus a plus b upon x minus a whole square this time. So this has to be learned. This is a table that has to be learned. The third is px square plus qx plus r, means numerator is a quadratic equation. Denominator can be resolved into three factors, x minus a, x minus b, x minus c product. Then you will do nothing but these three are individually taken in the form of a upon x minus a, b upon x minus b, c upon x minus c. The fourth form, again a quadratic in the numerator, denominator has a whole square and x minus b, that means separate factor. So again a upon the whole square one will be taken first individually, x minus a, then whole square will be taken together along x minus a whole square, then the last factor x minus b will be taken here. Last but not the least, if I have such a form wherein px square plus qx plus r is a quadratic, denominator has one factor and the other factor is a quadratic which cannot be factorized further. Mind it, this cannot be factorized further, x square plus bx plus c. Then what to do? Then you are going to adopt this method, this format, a upon the x minus a factor plus bx plus c upon that factor which cannot be factorized further. So a, b, c here are going to be real numbers and we are going to learn many questions. The understanding, the concepts will be there for partial fractions in the next video that follows.